they're not thinking negative, because they're not in their pretty booming voice for this. How do you like that? That's super cool.
Totally different teaching style. I'm really high energy, and I have
eliminate either high school class and desk positions completely. So, this was my guy. I'm doing not to thank because he was very well-liked and liked kids, and he's been very well-liked. But isn't it incredible that when you have a teacher in your childhood, and I'm sure that all of you attest to this, there's probably one teacher that you can think back to.
I can, my first grade teacher, Nina Slayman.
But it may be the person I am today. All of the musicians in my life, all the directors, all the teachers, learning from other kinds of instrumentalists, learning from other kinds of teachers, builds a more well-rounded student. And so it gives you the opportunity to get different aspects or different thought processes from lots of different areas and inform your own style of musicianship. So, as I'm trying to remind all the children of that, I want to also remind them that yes, sometimes change is hard, but fruitful and beautiful things can come out of change as well. So, I'm really grateful to Mr. Smada. He's certainly fueled a lot of musical dreams in these kids, and they will be forever grateful. So, speaking of dreams, our show is all about dreams, and coming alive, being present, daring to dream big. The dreamers of the world, the movers and the shakers that are getting some stuff done. And not just sitting around, we gotta have them kind of up and moving. So we want to be thinking, we want to be producing a lot of wonderful, beautiful things and putting it out in the world for good. There have been times when I can see the glimmers of the fire in their eyes. I know it's in them. I know it's in them. But they're also still kind of trying to come up to the terms that it's different now. But again, change is necessary sometimes. And I told them, I'm going to love you through all the sass. I will. I want to keep loving you through the sass. One of these days, you're all going to look at me and go, ah, thank you so much for making me not quit. Thank you so much. Anyway, I really appreciate you. Here we're going to start this off with the junior high band. Again, we're not perfect, and we're little, but we're working on it, and we're getting there. We're getting there. And if anything is different than what I just heard in the band room, then y'all missed it. I'm sorry about that, because it was super good in the band room. Maybe we can recreate it, right?
Thank you.
Is this still on? Okay, great. I would like to ask a few of our students to stand up, please. Could I please have Katie Addick stand up? How about Avery Frank? How about Miles Lee? And Lucas Helper? All right. For Illinois Music Educators Association District Festival, ILMEA. Now, Lucas is a senior this year, and he writes his own music. He's worked on a composition, and he decided to put his composition into the adjudication process and the jury to see if he can make it in and have a little bit more feedback and go into the District Festival with his, composition. We won't hear about the results of those composition adjudications until early December. But we would really wish that he does really well. So give him a round of applause so that we can thank him for it. Now, our others, Miles B, right? We've got Katie, yeah, and we've got Avery. Avery, you're a freshman, and Katie, you're a sophomore? Junior. Sorry. Okay. Katie plays flute. Avery plays percussion and is a vocalist. And of course, Miles is our first chair clarinet for junior high. I'm happy to report that as of today, all three of you have made it into the ILMEA district festival.
Thank you. Thank you.
I love that. That's so powerful. I just don't know if you got any ideas, but okay. All right. Thank you so much for coming tonight. I hope you've enjoyed the show. Like I said, we're a work in progress. I think that it's starting to sound pretty good. It's coming together. And there's always room for improvement on anything that you do in life. So I'm going to keep moving with that kind of thought process. And I'm going to keep steaming ahead. And we're going to learn some more music. And we're going to put some more heart into it. So I know that many of you probably were, those that are here, were probably at the football games, correct? Right? Let me know if you were at the halftime football game. Or the, you saw the halftime show. All right, well, that was a magical thing for us to put together. We didn't have a great big ginormous budget. We only had 11 kids in the marching band. We don't have great big coaches coming down from Chicago to teach drill patterns off spreadsheets and all sorts of stuff. It was just us 11, brainstorming in the band room with a great big giant wall on a whiteboard behind me. And we would do a whole bunch of thought on how we could make some maneuvers, right? How could we make some stuff move around the field? How could we make it look super cool? And so the entire whiteboard back there for the first quarter of this year looked like a football playbook. It was just crazy arrows going everywhere across the field and across the board, and we had to try and get it together. All at the same time, that high school, remember I told you I was back here in March with my arts day, right? K-5. So when I came in, I'm thinking, oh, yeah, I know everybody. I know these kids. Well, I didn't know the high schoolers. And I didn't know the junior highs. I knew the kids that were fifth grade, now they're sixth grade this year. But I didn't know any of those kids, and they didn't know me. And they didn't know I was super fun, but they didn't know me. So we had to do a little hiccups in there, too. But it took them a while to finally realize, hey, we're about to do something super cool. We're about to do some stuff we've never done before. And she believes in us enough to be able to do this. So we're going to try it out. And so we did. And the first day came, and we were all just so excited. We couldn't believe we pulled it off. We did. Everything that was on that sheet, everything that was on that board, we did. We high fived, we took pictures, we cried, we hugged, it was all good. The breakthrough moment happened that night. And I'm like, yes, I'm in. Yes. All right. I'm not the other band director, but I'm this band director. We can do it. We can make big things, even though we're 11 kids. It might be a little, but we're very mighty. And then the halftime show for the homecoming game. Do we add another song or two? Or do we completely rip apart the show that we just spent the first quarter doing and completely deliver something new and more fabulous? And keep in mind, there's only 11 of us. But I do have my friend Mrs. Wolfer, who went up into the announcer's booth to get the aerial shot into the video so I could see. Do the orbit in three different directions at the same time? And do we make a giant triangle? Do we make a great star? The theme of the thing was outer space. So we had to make a star. And I could do that with 11 kids at 11 points. So a lot of times when you watch a marching band competition, it's fabulous. Holy smokes, it's so cool. And then you realize that there's like 150 kids or more in that band. And so you could see it on her face. You could see it. The air in the room was just like, we're not going to be able to do this. And I'm like, yes, yes. We're going to be able to do it. Yes. But I'm like, no, we're going to do it. It's going to happen. And if you come in early, and we practice, and you stay after school, and if on the day of the games, you get here at 4 o'clock, an hour and a half before, I mean, they get out of school, like 4:05, 3:15, somewhere there. They have you back from home, change your clothes, grab a snack, and back. Meet me on the field. One just worked. We ran through that show. And then I went. And that last push to the line, and I just stood out there and I went, hey, my dear little, we are very mighty. And I was very proud of them because it was an amazing thing to watch how they finally let all their guards down and they realized we're about to build something super cool here. And we all came together and I could see the fire. And I could feel that team spirit. We both went on that field on halftime. It was an all-in. And they didn't know what was wrong. I'm like, surely they watched the show before, right? I had them huddle up. Come on. We're just as important as the football team. Don't tell me any different. We are. Come on. Hands in. We all handed in. And I said, we can do it. They didn't say anything. I'm like, we can do it. accomplish anything. Man, right? A super fabulous in its own right. And we can accomplish anything as long as we put our heart into it. All right? So for all of the mistakes or little flips here and there tonight, we're a work in progress and we are really happy together. I am happy to be here to help with your program. So have your school, so have this program. We have the band boosters and a bunch of people that I want to thank. Well, my band is getting ready. My band is ready, but I'm not ready yet. Okay, my thank yous this evening. Okay, let's see. I want to thank, first and foremost, Don Meisler for making that call to me. All right? And just having this conversation and realizing that, you know, these kids, I can't let your school go quiet. I've got to come in and I've got to do something. And I want to thank Mr. Huber for being really supportive for me and helping answer a bunch of questions all the time. And I want to thank Mr. Bryan, our superintendent, for always being there to answer a bunch of questions for me. And my wonderful aide, Mrs. Colbert, who's out there with the band right now, just answering a bunch of questions for me. And she's also asking me a bunch of questions and we're brainstorming back there on how can we make this better, 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 better. I also have the band boosters that have just been an incredible delight to work with because they do so much behind the scenes, you have no idea. Decorations, tailgating parties for the marching band prior to, not just our marching band, but the other Weathersfield. They feed them, they cook for them, they feed them before every game. They come in and they help. They come in and they help organize the band room. I'll tell you, oh my God, it was a nice unit of it. Working on band, cleaning the band uniforms, all of that. It takes a village, like I said before. If anybody's ever interested in making sure that you ensure the longevity of this program, we need more parents to get active in the band music program. We really do. Anybody who is willing and able that can help us with anything, from moving a bunch of heavy stuff to transporting, helping us get kids to games, things like that, we're all in. All right, we really would love to have you on board. So I'm going to have now, let me see if I've got anybody. Oh, wait, a few more things. The janitorial staff, the maintenance crew, Ty and Rod and Cindy and Marsha. Holy smokes. I just, so many questions behind the scenes. Helping me move stuff, cleaning stuff, finding little random odds and ends, announcing things, come just powwowing with me so that we can get it all done. Let's see, I've got the parents. Gosh, thank you guys. Seriously. You guys all owe yourselves a round of applause because you've got to teach your high in band, which is one of the hardest things to do. So give yourselves a round of applause. Because the AD program in junior high years is really difficult. I work in a lot of schools all across the country, and I see it more in junior high than anything. They're pulled in a million different directions. A lot of different clubs, a lot of different activities, a lot of extracurriculars, a lot of sports, you name it. And sports that aren't even a part of things in your school, like bow hunting. Now, I know you do hunting, you're a big hunting town here, but for us, not from Geneseo. And I had no idea because we didn't go to Geneseo when I grew up. But you guys all had a day where y'all were fun. I didn't know that that was a thing. So there are people that have their kids that are kind of getting extra help in some of those extracurricular activities as well. And that takes up your time. And then it comes to that point where you got homework, and you got all these activities, and they look for a band. And so we have little bands, and we need big bands. Because music makes the world go round. And music puts humanity and compassion and empathy and love and joy and wonder into this world. And we all know that this world is filled with so much ugliness. We need beauty. We need the music. I need to be part of band boosters. I need to get your little ones in any music class to find them, find them out here. I need to get excited about music because holy smokes, we're not to. And I just asked that some really loud stuff. And they told me, we can't do that in the gym. That's going to be so loud, their ears are going to bleed. And I'm like, I know it. So delicious. For a second. It's going to be loud. So if you got little kids or anybody that's super sensitive to loud stuff, I'm just giving them a little bit. All right? So, thank you so much, parents, for helping your children continue to show up to band every day, for bringing their instruments in, for reminding them to practice. And if you aren't doing that, please remind them to practice, because I remind them every day. I set aside a couple of mornings that would be helpful for them, because I'm not here during their MTSS for their study hall time at the end of the day. I have another school that I've got to go to, and then I teach all night long until about 1 o'clock at night. Go home, eat breakfast for the day, go to bed, wake up, and I'm here. I live in Bedford, but I drive. My school is in Geneseo, so I hear I'm already in this area. So, when they say, hey, I'll be here at 7:30 in the morning, I need your help, I'm here at 7:30 in the morning. And then they don't show up. So, they know about it. I will be here, bells ringing, Wednesday mornings. Early bird. If you want them to have extra practice, and you want them to get some extra help, I'm here at 7:30 in the morning on Wednesday mornings, starting next week. I will be here for any junior high band student that shows up. We'll just keep working on our music, we'll get better, better, better. Friday morning, 7:30, fifth graders. They need the most help of all right now, because I don't get to see them a little bit. I only get to see the kids 3 times a week, for maybe about a half an hour, if we're lucky, because we've got to like put the instruments together, and then put the instruments away. And man, I love them every day for an hour. I love them for 3 hours. They wouldn't love them until they started really getting good, and then they let. So we've got to get them really good, so they love it, and they want to be here all the time. All right. Now, thank you to all the children. My last one. Thank you very much. The growing pains have been difficult. This class is special. I know that. But thank you for showing up tonight. And thank you for helping whenever you could in the band room with anybody that needed extra help. And thank you for not giving me too many gray hair. Gave me a few, just not super. Thank you for all my choir students, my tiny little choirs, for pulling together these big voices. Hopefully you can hear them. Could you hear them? Yeah? All right. And thank you to my marching band out in the hallway. I hope you can hear me. I appreciate you. I see all of you, and I see all of the wonderful things that you're doing in your life, and I'm very proud of all of you. I'm proud of all of you sitting here, because it takes hot minute to get these kids to realize that music is really fun, even when it's by a brand new drum. So, we're going to kick this off, this finale, off of our marching band. We've been working on a new cadence for the bass drum. Hopefully, we'll hear that here in just a second. Before we do go, Liz Weed, are you here? Here you are. She wanted to say a few things for band boosters.